Some labs in chemistry class, so we want to make sure you know all the safety rules.
Exactly.
Yep.
Okay.
And then some.
Right, exactly.
Yes.
So, you know what? I left my procedure laying over there, just like
you want
a
me
kid.
To?
I'll
yep.
get it.
Okay.
And you can tell us what we have sitting up.
All right. What do you have in here? It's a beaker.
Yep. We have some copper chloride.
And a scopula.
Right.
And some aluminum foil.
All right.
Well, let me get a thermometer and we'll be all set.
And we need a thermometer. So, Ms. Grace.
Yeah.
Okay.
There you go.
Perfect.
So, we have to follow the procedure. That's why I went to get it. Because if you don't have the directions, you might do something you shouldn't do.
Yes.
Follow your procedure. All of this stuff, up to drawing in the data and the graph, needs to be in their composition notebooks before you come in for lab that day.
That's the pre-lab, right?
Right.
Okay.
It's called the
yep.
pre-lab because we do it before the lab.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, good. So the first step is to get copper chloride into the beaker. Do you think this is okay for a student to scoop out their own copper chloride?
For copper chloride,
we have a safety symbol, a lot of safety symbols on here, but it's corrosive is our main issue.
Yeah.
So only somebody wearing gloves can dispense this.
And we don't have gloves on.
Right. We don't have enough gloves for everybody.
Yeah.
So your teachers are going to be the ones wearing gloves and dispensing this chemical.
Okay.
Right.
Right.
And we can tell by looking at the numbers on the side what it is we need. For instance, since this corrosiveness shows a 3, that means we need to be careful, extra careful.
Right. Okay, so once we get this into here, we're going to make observations of the powder all by itself.
Yes.
Right.
Because the whole point of this lab is to observe a chemical change.
Yes.
So we have to see what it was like before.
Before we're going to do anything.
Yeah, and what it turns into after.
Exactly.
We're also going to take the temperature of that solution before we put the aluminum foil in there.
Okay.
Because the foil is going to react with the copper chloride. So we have to take the temperature before. So once you've got the powder dissolved in water, that's just a physical change.
Right.
Right? So we take the temperature. Make sure that you take the cover off. Most of my students
have
already
yeah.
discovered it works better when the cover's off.
Exactly.
And you need to measure in Celsius.
Right. And you also need to make sure it's on.
Right.
I've already had people asking me how to turn them on.
Right.
I said, read the buttons.
Yes. Right.
Yeah.
So then we'll take the before temperature, and then I'm going to start a timer on my screen. You guys can do a timer any way you want,
yeah.
or each individual kid can do
right.
their own.
Yeah, exactly.
Right? But
mm-hmm.
every 30 seconds?
Yes.
Yeah, every 30 seconds
yeah.
we take a temperature reading
right.
and graph the results. And that's it for the copper chloride then.
Right.
Cool.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Just be safe.